Hello everyone. Today we are going to be discussing how we can easily draw our CFA model in AMOS using the Pattern Matrix Model Builder plugin, which is available as a third-party plugin. Now, before we begin this session, I assume that you have already worked on EFA and you know how to do it on how to do the analysis on SPSS, as well as you are familiar with the working of the software called as AMOS. Now, plugins are basically of two types as far as AMOS is concerned. There are certain plugins which have been developed by IBM, which owns AMOS, and there are certain plugins which have been developed by researchers across the world. So we'll be using a third-party plugin developed by Professor James Gaskin. And if you want to download the plugin, I've provided the link. It is available. The link is going to be available to you in the description. You can click on the link and it will take you to the folder. So once you click on this link, it will take you to this Google Drive, and you have on this Google Drive, you have certain AMOS built-in plugins which are provided by AMOS itself, and then you have a folder called as Estimands, and then you have the plugins for AMOS which are for different versions. So this is for version, the one that you see, it is for version 23 or lower. And this is for version 24 or higher, depending on the version that you have. I have version 24. I use version 24. And then you have plugins for version 26 or higher. So what you can do is you can simply right click on this and you can download the entire folder on your desktop or wherever you feel comfortable on your computer or your laptop. I have done the same and I'll show you how to install this particular plugin called AMOS Plugins and Estimands, which you can see when I click on this. I have the version 23 or lower, I have the version 24, and I have the version 26. And in my case, I need version 24. So what I'll do is, I can, the procedure is the same for installing all these different plugins that you have here. So there's a folder which contains many plugins and they're all very useful plugins. So I strongly suggest that you install all these plugins. But today we are only going to be discussing Pattern Matrix Builder. So if you want to install this, what will you do? You will just simply click on the properties, and then there will be an option here which will say unblock. So in my case, I've already installed it, so it is not saying unblock, but you will see something here below the advanced tab. You will see an unblock. Check that. And you click on apply and hit the button OK. Now, for example, maybe it is available in the multi-group. Let me just show it to you. You can see when I have clicked on the multi-group, so you can see there is an unblock option here. So I'll click on this. I'll click on the apply button and OK. So I have to do the same thing for all these plugins. So once I have done the exercise for all these plugins, what I need to do is I need to simply copy all of them. So I'll just copy them. And I can copy whichever I need, or I can simply copy all of them. So I'll select these and I'll simply copy them. And the way to install is different in version 23 or lower, and the way to install in version 24 and above is completely different. So in case of version 24 and above, you just copy all these and then you have to go to the users. So you will have to go to the users, and in my case, this is the user that I am. So I'll click on this. So I'll click on myself as a user, and then I'll go to app data. So app data, you need to go to app data. Once you go to app data, you need to click on the local, and on local, you click on AMOS development, and in AMOS, you have to go to whichever version that you have. So earlier I had 26. That's why you see a remnant of 26 here, but I use 24. And then after clicking on 24, you go to plugins and just copy paste everything. Since I have each one of them here, so I'm not doing the, or I'm not repeating the exercise again, but you can simply do this, but make sure that all of these are unblocked. Once you have done this, you can simply, so when you go to the plugins, you simply see the Pattern Matrix Model Builder. And this is the one that you need to build a CFA model, and which saves you a lot of time. How do we do this? I'll tell you. I have an SPSS file here on which I want to run a factor analysis. So I'll simply go to the recent dialogues or the recent analysis that I've done, I'll go to factor analysis. I've already selected the variables that I want to factor. I've selected everything. I'll just hit the button OK. And I look at the results. So basically, I'm interested in the results. And which you know, table that I'm interested in? I'm interested in the pattern matrix. So if I have used orthogonal rotation like varimax or quatimax or equimax, this pattern matrix would not be there. It would be called as rotated. And if I have used a rotation, obviously this is a form of rotation. So I'll be using the rotated factor matrix. Here it is the pattern matrix. So I'll just copy this. Always make sure that you copy this pattern matrix. And I'll simply copy this and I need to come here and I need to open the plugins. And when I open the plugin, it will ask me to specify a data file. So the first thing that you need to do in AMOS is you need to specify a data file. So I'll search for the file. And in my case, my EFA was done on this particular data set. And I'm going to select the same data set. And now the data set has been, you know, and this pattern matrix dialog box is opened up. Now when I paste this pattern matrix and when I'll hit the button create diagram, it will not run. And there's a particular reason why it will not run. I'll tell you. The reason being that I have chosen the labels. In fact, I have to choose the name of the items. And when I hit the button create diagram, there will be an error. And I need to, if I hit continue, I need to close down the entire program and open it up again. So let me do that. So I've opened up AMOS once again. My AMOS had crashed because I had made a simple mistake, and because of that, I was not able to draw the CFA diagram. And this is a mistake which many of us make, and that is why I wanted to highlight how this issue can be resolved. So again, we'll go back to our output, and we can see in the case of our output, we have the names and the labels both here. Now, what does this mean? If we go back to our, you know, the variable view, we can see our variable that I've chosen is item 1, item 2, item 3, and they have their labels. So these are the labels. Now, the problem in pattern matrix builder is that it will never take the labels. It will only take the names. So how do we correct that? That has to be corrected before we run an analysis. And normally, we take these as labels because we want to make sense out of if these would have just been number item 1, item 2, item 3 and so on and so forth, we would not be able to meaningfully unless and until we keep on referring, you know, each time to see what this particular item is, the name of the item or the label. So grouping or giving it a theoretical name becomes a little bit cumbersome. So that is why we use this in the analysis. But it is very simple. With one simple click, we can actually go to edit options and we have to go to the output, and under this variables in label shown as, so we not use labels, we'll use the names, and that's it. We'll hit the button apply and okay, and we'll rerun the analysis. Everything as it is, we'll run the analysis, and you can see if we scroll down, now you can see the same pattern matrix and you can see they're merely items now. And when these are items, I can simply copy them and they don't have the labels now. I'll go back here and again, the same process, I'll have to associate the data file or I have to join the data file with the project, and my data file is this. I've selected this. This is exactly the same data file that I had done my EFA on, and this becomes okay. And the best practice is to save the file, but since I am just demonstrating how to make the CFA diagram, I'm not saving this project. So I'll go to plugins and I'll hit the button pattern map. Okay, so I have this here, the window, and I can simply paste the pattern matrix, and you can see the pattern is without the matrix is without the labels. It has the names only, and I'll hit create diagram, and you can see a nice beautiful diagram has been created. Now I can save this to whichever name that I'm interested in, CFA, demo, whatever you would want to save it as, and then you can run the appropriate analysis. So it saves a lot of time, and not only the time, you have a lot of arrows going in, coming out, you have the error terms which you have to name, and you have to then drag and drop all the respective, the values in these, boxes. So that takes a little bit of time. So this saves life. So this saves, this makes life very, very easy for us. This saves time. And in that way, AMOS is lagging far behind software such as PLSM. You can do these things in PLSM very, very quickly. Now, this is one problem that you will encounter. There is another problem that you will encounter, especially in version 24. The problem is that once you were to use the plugin, okay, in one session, you will not be able to use it again. Let us say that I made a mistake or something else, I just want to redraw this model. I made a simple mistake. So I'll just go and use another plugin to erase everything. I've erased everything. Now I want to redo the entire thing. So again, I have to go to plugins and then I'll say pattern matrix. But once I do this, it says cannot access a disposed object. What does it actually mean? It means that if in a particular session, you have run the pattern matrix model builder once, that means you will have to close your AMOS and you will have to reopen it again. And again, you will have to follow the same process. So if you reopen this, you will have to associate the data file because the data file won't be associated. Or you could open up the, or if you have saved it, I'll just, once again, I need to associate the data file. Now my data file is this. It has been associated, okay, and I can use the plugins now. I'll go to pattern matrix model builder and I'll copy the pattern matrix that I'm interested in. I'll bring it here and I'll just paste it and I'll create the diagram and voila, the diagram is here. So these are two major issues which you encounter and these are the ways through which you can resolve the issues. So once if you have made a mistake, you'll have to close down AMOS, reopen it again, and then start the plugin. In the other case is that when you have not changed, the display. Here the display is in the form of names, not the labels. But in the previous example that we had taken, so this is an example where we had taken the labels. So when we choose the labels, the pattern matrix model builder will not build the CFA diagram for us. In fact, it's going to hang and then you will have to shut down the program manually and then you will have to reopen it again. Thank you.